Welcome everyone. We are on the 8th tutorial in this series. In this tutorial, we will first demonstrate how the measure timer instruction elements work in LD Micro and how to use them. Then, we will add some timer instructions to improve the functionality of the simple alarm logic we created in tutorial 7. Timers can activate or deactivate different output components after a predetermined time interval has elapsed. The available timer types in LD Micro are turn on delay timer, turn off delay timer, pulse timers, which are timer high and timer low, retentive timer and retentive timer low, and finally, cyclic timer. The turn on delay timer can be identified by TON, the time interval, and the variable name. When the timer input signal is true for the specified time interval, its output is delayed for that time interval before it will become true. The output will immediately become false once the input changes to false. If before the specified time interval elapsed and the input goes false, the output will not become true. To demonstrate its operation, insert a turn-on delay timer between a contact and a coil from the temporization option of the instruction menu. Double-click on it and type onDelay as the variable name. Assign a delay time of 2000 milliseconds, which is the same as 2 seconds. Simulate the program and double-click on X switch. Observe the increasing value of the TONDelay state in the lower window. The timer value is increased by 1 in each PLC cycle time, as specified in the PLC configuration window from tutorial 2. Thus, the final value of TONDelay is 0x00C8 in hexadecimal, which is equal to 200 instead of 2000 milliseconds, then equal to 2 seconds. When the time interval elapsed, while lead is then activated, double-click on X switch again. Observe that while lead is immediately deactivated and TONDelay state is reset to 0. Next, double-click on X switch and double-click again before the time interval elapsed. Notice that TONDelay state is reset to 0. The value of TONDelay can be used in other sections of the ladder program with its variable name. Change the delay value of TONDelay to 4000. Insert a rung below rung 1. From the instruction menu and compare variable option, click on Insert GEQ, compare for greater than or equal. Double-click on the instruction element and type the timer variable name in the close if text box. Change the greater than or equal value to 100. Also, insert a coil on the same rung and name it lead 1. Repeat the previous steps in 2 additional rungs using the same timer variable name, but with the greater than or equal values being 200 or 300 respectively. Name their coils as lead 2 and lead 3 respectively. Simulate the program and double-click on X switch to activate the timer. Observe that while lead 1 comes on at 1 second, then while lead 2 at 2 seconds, then while lead 3 at 3 seconds, and finally while lead at 4 seconds. Observe on the breadboard how the LEDs are sequentially turned on at an interval of 1 second when the switch is held down. Now, let's go on to the turn-off delay timer. The turn-off delay timer is identified by TOF, the time interval, and the variable name. When the timer input signal goes from true to false and remains false for the specified time interval, its output is delayed for that time interval before it will become false. The output will become true once the input changes to true. If before the specified time interval is completed and the input goes true, the output will remain true. Let's demonstrate the functionality of the turn-off delay timer. Insert a turn-off delay timer between a contact and a coil from the temporization option of the instruction menu as in the previous example. Name it off delay and assign a time interval of 2000 milliseconds to it. Simulate and double-click on X switch. Observe that while lead is immediately turned on. Double-click again on X switch and observe that while lead is turned off after 2 seconds. The timer high and the timer low are pulse timers. The timer high instruction produces a fixed output pulse when its input goes from false to true, while the timer low operates in the reverse, where its output goes low for a fixed period when its input goes from true to false. The retentive timer is similar to the turn-on delay timer. Unlike the turn-on delay timer, the retentive timer does not reset when the input becomes false before the time interval elapses, but rather, the input true times are successively added up until the specified time elapses. The RES instruction from the counter option is used to reset the retentive timer. This timer may be used to write a program that determines the total operating time of a device or equipment. The retentive timer low operates just like the retentive timer but with a low-level input. The cyclic timer produces a continuous on-off output. The on time is always equal to the off time as specified in the timer delay. We can also create a program that works like the cyclic timer with turn-on delay and turn-off delay timers. Insert a turn-on delay and a turn-off delay timers between a contact and a coil. Assign a time interval of 500 milliseconds to both timers. Name the contact and the coil as clock. Change the contact and the coil to internal relays and negate the contact. Insert a rung below rung 1 and insert a contact and a coil in it. Set the contact to be an internal relay and assign it the variable name of clock. Name the coil as lead. Simulate the program and observe that arrow clock is repeatedly turned on and off by the timers, which then flashes while lead in rung 2. When the program is tested on the breadboard, the LED is observed to blink every second. You can set the time interval of each timer differently to either prolong the on time of the LED or its off time. This is what differentiates it from the cyclic timer with the same on and off time. Considering the set-reset latch program from tutorial 7, insert a timer high instruction between the contact and the set-only coil in rung 1. Insert a turn-on delay timer after the timer high instruction. Name them high and on delay respectively. Assign time intervals of 2010 milliseconds and 2000 milliseconds to them respectively. Insert a turn-off delay timer between the contact and the reset-only coil in rung 2 and name it off delay. Simulate the program and notice that while lead on is delayed for 2 seconds when X start is activated. T high duration extended by 10 milliseconds retains the X start input signal to the timer to prevent a reset before the specified time interval elapses. When the X stop is activated, a delay of 2 seconds is observed before while lead goes off. Finally, let us add some of these timers to the simple alarm program in tutorial 7. Insert a rung before rung 1. Then, insert a negated internal relay contact with the variable name pulse, a turn-on delay timer with the variable name on pulse, a turn-off delay timer with the variable name off pulse and an internal relay coil with the variable name as the contact. Assign a delay time of 200 milliseconds and 1100 milliseconds to the turn on and turn off delay timers respectively. Insert a turn on delay timer beside Y switch 1 LED and assign it a delay time of 5000 milliseconds. Cut Y switch 2 LED contacts with the cut selected element tool from the edit menu and paste it below Y switch 2 LED with the paste rungs or element into rung 2 from the edit menu. Insert a cyclic timer beside Y alarm activated LED with a time interval of 500 milliseconds and a variable name of blink. Finally, insert an internal relay contact beside Y buzzer and name it pulse. Simulate the program or test it on a breadboard circuit. Observe that when any or both of the door switches are activated, the LED comes on, but the alarm activated LED and the buzzer activation are delayed for 5 seconds. Thereafter, the alarm activated LED starts blinking at a duty cycle of 1 second and the buzzer beeps at a duty cycle of 1.3 seconds, with the on time longer than the off time. When the intruder alarm is initially triggered via the door switches, press the alarm reset button to deactivate the alarm activated LED and the buzzer and reset the alarm. Now we can move on to our next tutorial where we will create a car parking lot counter. But please click on the subscribe button so you can get notification of new videos. See you soon.